Hi, my lovely subscribers. Excuse my puffiness in the hair. When you have curls, this is usually what happens. So if you're planning to make like small curls, don't. I like them like when they're like day old, but 2 days or 3 days, they look awful. Anyways, I'm so sorry for the breaks in between the Dimash's latest video reaction that I have done. I'm so sorry. I try my best not to do that in this video, only because I did it only because I didn't know, because it's a new song that he hasn't even released, so I was careful because I didn't know, like, maybe they didn't want people reacting to it before it was even released. But I didn't get copyright on it, so, you know, I feel sorry. I'm so sorry that I paused so much. Also, if you are very don't like watching ads, you can always download ad blocker, even though it's the only income we make. Most of the YouTubers don't get sponsorships or anything, so most of us just make money from ads that you watch or skip. We make a bit more money, I think, when you watch a full ad, or just a bit less money when you watch like a 10-second ad and skip it. You don't have to watch ads, you can always download a ad blocker, but you know, you are helping your favorites try by not doing that. So if you can watch ads on TV that are 5 minutes, you can probably watch an ad that is like 30 minutes long. Not 30 minutes, what am I saying? 10 or 30 seconds, whatever, long. You know, I do it all the time. I have an ad block, however, I don't use it on YouTube because I want to support my favorites. So yeah, anyways, most of us don't get ads on all videos. That's why we highly monetize others. So most of our content gets copyrighted, and if something doesn't, that's great for us, so we can at least make money on that content, even though we don't make any money on other content, you know. So, you know, it's a compromise, I think, and I don't think you should be that mad on me or anyone who puts ads on like a 10-minute or 15-minute video. It takes a long time to upload those videos, edit them, and do everything in one day, which I do 2 times a day. That's very, you know, it takes up a lot of my time, but I love you and I want to give you as much content as I can daily. So let's just start recording. We're reacting to new Dimash's song called I think Lay Down. Yeah, I think someone told me Lay Me Down, so I thought he was doing a cover on Sam Smith's song. Yeah, anyway, let's start recording in 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, good. What is this? Okay, maybe this one is the rock. Wait, let me see if this is lyrics. No. Let me try to taste, cause I can't forget all. Bitch, I'm shook! This is easy to forgive and it's good enough for better. This is a whole bop. Oh, I'm so happy. Let me just wipe my nose. I'm sorry, I have allergies. Also, my eyes are get watery when I hear Dimash. It doesn't matter if it's a sad song. So let me just chill for a second. So you guys don't have to worry about me. I do have sinus problems, but it's mostly allergy related and also mostly like just deviated septum, so don't worry. Oh, this is a whole, oh, good song. Let me try His low notes have been improving rapidly. Sorry, there's something stuck on my lip. What the? Okay, good. Yeah, anyways, his low notes have been improving rapidly. I think he is more comfortable now in both, like, high notes and low notes. So I think that is amazing because it gives him more opportunity to do songs that are lower in the register and that he can still execute them as well as he would like high notes. So that is amazing. This song is like you can hear a bit more lower, you know, toned. I don't know which genre this is, but it's so good. I can see some rock influences in this. Nice. 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 Sorry. Nice, I love the vibrato he puts in this song. It's very powerful, not overwhelmingly, you know, powerful, but powerful enough to elevate this song much than it would be without it. If it would be just straight notes, it wouldn't be that vocally interesting, I think. Wow, all the little riffs and runs that he does at the end of the lines, it's amazing. And I think this song really, really suits him. I think it suits his voice very well, and I think it will go far. I think I don't know why he hasn't uploaded it on his channel, but hopefully he will. Nice. Oh, beautiful. See, beautiful. Nice. Thank you.
Lay down your pride and I'll show you the way we go. Head to head, don't fold, now get up. Get
Nice. I like this stripped down version at the end, you know, where the instruments are lowered and the bass is not that hard, so you get to see his voice more. Nice. My baby did that. Okay, let's stop recording. Anyways, let me just tell you why I like this song a lot. I like that it's on English, one, because it could, you know, reach a higher, like, wider audience. I personally prefer songs on Russian or Kazakh language because it is a more beautiful language to me. I'm also someone who is known to like songs that are different languages because they sound more exotic, more new and fresh to me, even though I listen to Russian music, you know, a lot because I react to a lot of it. But it's still new and fresh to me more than English is, because, you know, people in other countries always listen to songs in English. So I think it is a smart choice, but I think I like the first song I react to better because it's a ballad and it shows his full range, shows his low notes and everything. I think this shows, of course, like his range, but it doesn't show it as well as the other song. I think this is more pop influenced, almost pop rock, something along those lines. I don't know where to place it in genres because there's no clear, you know, it's not clear to me what genre this is. Someone who is maybe musically educated could tell me that in the comments, or someone who just knows. Let me just see if there's something in the description. No, I don't know. So anyways, I think this is a very good and smart way to, you know, introduce more normie people like Americans to him who don't know him, maybe through this song or something like that. I think song is pretty well written. Lyrics are catchy, you know. They're nothing profound, I think. I think when he gets songs, his English songs are much more simpler than his Russian songs, which is understandable, of course, because I think he works with... I don't think he works with American, like, writers. I think he works with Russian or Kazakh or Chinese writers. So I think his songs in different languages all have, like Kazakh songs are maybe the highest lyrically, to me, the best lyrically. Then come Russian songs, then Chinese, then American. That's how I think complex his songs are lyrically. So I think that's why I enjoy maybe Russian songs more. And I can relate to the ethno sound more because I listen to it, you know, in my country. Ethno sound is very popular. Folk music is very popping here, you know, everyone listens to it. Even if I don't listen to it, even if I don't search for it, I get it. Even if I go to a club, it's mostly folk music and with influences of pop or rap, of course. However, mostly folk. So I relate more to him singing in Russian than English. I think his English is improving and it's really, really getting good, almost fluent-like. So I'm very happy for him. I think he will... I can't wait to see him, you know, upload something more on his original channel, because I feel sorry that all these, like, fan channels are getting his songs and uploading it to the world, but he didn't. So let me just see if he did. This is channel I found just because... they have English subs, so... No. He just uploaded the teaser and his song called My Swan. Okay, so he didn't upload anything like that. Okay, so... Anyways, I hope you enjoy my reaction. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. It helps me out a lot, you know. And also subscribing to my channel means a lot, because we reached 30,000 subscribers. We are going towards 31,000 subscribers, which is amazing. I think that is a huge accomplishment for me, coming from a small town, and no one in my town knows I do YouTube. I just tell, I'm working on the internet. You don't need to know, like, because I think as little as people know about you, you get more happiness from that. Only my partner, my parents, and my two close friends know about it. And one person from my high school, because she found me on her own. I don't know how. But I don't mind her, because she's a nice person. She won't tell everyone, you know. So as little as people know about your happiness, I think your happiness will last longer. So that's why I don't tell anyone. But I really, really am proud of him, and he has come so far recently. I think he has, you know, bounced back from his quitting that awful, awful show. And I'm so glad he did, because I don't think they would have let him win. I think, you know, they wanted the kid to win. I don't know, like when I watched the full show, I watched it, but not on their channel, so I'm not giving them views. When I watched the full show, I realized it was more centered around kids, even though it wasn't. I thought TNT boys were eliminated because they were kids. No, I don't think they were because they were kids, but just because of some other favoritism that happened. I don't know what. I'm not going to talk about it too much, but I think he dodged the bullet there. And I wish him nothing but the best. If you ever see this, Dimash, love you, love you so much. I think you're the best singer ever, especially coming from Kazakhstan, especially male, especially, you know, just a handsome man who sings so well. Love you so much. Anyways, to all of my dears, I love you guys so much. I appreciate every single thing you comment. And yeah, I'll see you very soon. Next one. Bye.